Huh. Phoenix stumbled upon a winged creature, easily mistaken for a fairy. However, its true identity would soon be revealed.
So, what is it?
Phoenix would need to free it to find out. As Phoenix freed the small creature imprisoned on the isle, she let out a cry, which meant, "Great hero, I am but a piece of Nike, the goddess of victory. Please free the others, so I may return to my full glory."
They won't win without Nike. She's like a glove or a thing you wear that protects you while running. A helmet. Yeah, but you can tell me now.
Can you please respect my narrative pacing?
Yeah.
The Valley of Eternal Spring. Its highlights include a massive tree that reaches up to the heavens. The Hall of the Gods. Eros' Palace.
Oh, I'm glad he finally got his happy ending.
And a palace belonging to the Goddess of Beauty herself.
Of course Aphrodite would claim the prime real estate with the best view. As long as she's safe from prying eyes, I'm happy.
From such great heights, a fluttering of birds, feeding from the most beautiful apple tree, caught Phoenix's eye.
Phoenix was about as high as I was when I thought marrying Aphrodite off to Hephaestus would stop the other gods from fighting over her.
Yes, that view from Mount Olympus is something else. I haven't seen it in years.
You're not getting that high again, so stop asking!
Tell me the deeds of Golden Aphrodite, who subdues mortal men and birds in air, and the creatures on land and sea. Grant me a song. Stir up my sweetest passions.
Hey, watch it, buddy. That's my daughter-in-law you're talking about.
Unlike the mortal flesh, which had been frozen into marble, the pomegranate sprung forth defiantly, bursting with life.
A lot of poetry for something they're just going to stick in their mouth.
Isn't that what the best poetry is about?
Huh.
Ah, Aphrodite's palace. The most majestic sight on the Golden Isle's skyline.
I don't know if it's the most majestic. There's one mountain in particular I think is pretty... regal.
Attack! Cleanse this world of divine imperfection!
If you quit,
there are 6 prophecies about me!
We will pull back
like an extra virgin olive oil!
We have to protect the Golden Isle from Typhon's environmentalism!
Thank you. Coin, bearing Charon's mark.
Typhon stole those too? Charon was saving up for a bridge! Eros, what a mama's boy. Always doing whatever Aphrodite told him to. Like shooting Helen with his arrow to fulfill her bargain with Paris of Troy.
I wonder if Phoenix will test the power of an arrow on the Helen statue.
Thank you.
Poor Helen. Once Eros struck her with his arrow, she was powerless to do anything but leave her husband, Menelaus of Sparta, for Paris.
Ha! Might have offered Paris power, Hera, but it wasn't enough to win the Apple of Discord.
Of course not. It was a total turnoff. Paris didn't want power. He was a slave to love.
Athena, if Paris had known the Trojan War was coming, maybe he would have taken the battle wisdom you promised him in exchange for the apple. But alas...
Ha-ha! Time paradox!
Wow. You're smarter than I gave you credit for.
Oh, sorry. I nodded off for a second. What was that?
Never mind.
Come on.